I don't want you to block their side. You can just stand on the base level and make it over there.
Superior at City College. We need a real chancellor, someone who understands, and we need a board of trustees that was duly elected by the people of San Francisco. How would the board of supervisors feel? How would the mayor feel if he was arbitrarily removed from office? Where is the democracy in that? Who are these people? Where did they come from? They have not had transparency or accountability for years. and yet they have the nerve to raise the salaries of administrators in a backroom deal and ignore the teachers. They have the nerve to pepper spray our students who pay their salary. Mr. Agrella's salary comes from your pot of money, comes from your inability currently to choose the classes that you want. This is wrong. This is not Kiev. This is San Francisco. We want our board back, and we want it now. I have a handy piece of legislation that'll do just that, and I will say there's a number of other legislators who have introduced bills, and I applaud that. But I have to say to you, they need to be scrutinized before we jump in. Because we don't want a bill that is orchestrated by the state chancellor for his self-serving purposes. There's only one self-serving issue here, and that is democracy and empowerment of our students and our great institution, City College. Thank you so much.
Supervisor David Campos was there with students yesterday just after there was a very startling skirmish with police. Students occupied the administration building. He was there to talk to students about some of their concerns, and he was also there last night at Chinatown campus as we went in with community and students to talk about what was happening at City College and what the plans for City College are. He is going to talk to you about the resolution you put forward and what he knows about what's happening.
The resolution
for thank you!
Thank you, everyone. You know, you never want to follow Tom Amiano. Thank you, Tom Amiano, for everything you're doing in Sacramento.
Thank you.
And I want to thank the students, the faculty, the entire community at City College for being out here today, for your perseverance, and quite frankly, for your patience. This resolution is a long time coming, and this is not a radical resolution. It is a resolution that is predicated on the very basic concept that at the end of the day, City College of San Francisco belongs to the people of San Francisco. It is predicated on the principle that the people of San Francisco have a right constitutionally to elect people to represent them, to elect people to make decisions for them, and to do so openly, transparently. I want to thank not only Assemblymember Amiano, I see also my colleague John Avalos from the Board of Supervisors, but I want to acknowledge the duly elected members of the Board of Trustees of City College. If they could please come up, because I want you to see them. We have here three amazing individuals. Four. You know, they ran for office. They put their agendas forward, and the people elected them to represent them. And what's happening in City College right now is that decisions are being made behind closed doors without any transparency and without any input from the students, the faculty, the people that are ultimately impacted by those decisions. Was it a good idea to give double-digit pay raises to top administrators?
No!
Was it a good idea to see what happened yesterday on the Ocean campus with the student demonstration?
No!
The problem is that those things happen without any one of us having a say about them. And in so doing, we are taking away from City College what makes City College what it is, the fact that it is connected to people. So I want to thank my colleagues on the Board of Supervisors who have co-sponsored this resolution. We have a resolution that is already has more than enough of a majority to pass. I want to thank Supervisor Avalos who's here.
Thank you.
Supervisor Mars, Supervisor Wiener, Supervisor Yee, Supervisor Kim, Supervisor Chu, and Supervisor Cohen. We have eight members. members of the Board of Supervisors that are already on record saying it is time to bring democracy back.
Yeah.
And let me say this, because I want to reference the exact language of this resolution, because we're not shy about what we want to see, and we're not shy about when we want to see it. We want the following: that the state and the authorities that are responsible, and I quote, immediately restore the duly elected CCSF Board of Trustees the right to convene, discuss, and make decisions regarding CCSF's direction and progress. And we also want the full restoration of the duly elected Board of Trustees by removing the special trustee with extraordinary powers as soon as possible. Now, I do want to say something about what I saw yesterday. You know, I went to the Mission to the Ocean campus. I went to the Chinatown campus, and I was really disheartened to see what happened at the Ocean campus. I don't want to prejudge what happened, but I think that at a minimum we need a full investigation over the incident that led to the pepper spraying of the student. And the very fact that that happened tells us that something is amiss at City College. You know, if our police department ever does something to a citizen or ever engages in any kind of interaction with a citizen, we have civilian oversight in San Francisco. In our San Francisco Police Department, any one of us can go to the Office of Citizens' Complaints and file a complaint. And that complaint process is there not only to protect the public, but also to protect the police officer. But what happened yesterday was that a member of the City College Police Department engaged in this conduct. Without prejudging what happened, what bothers me is that I don't know that there is an actual mechanism in place that allows for a full investigation to happen. It is entirely up to the special trustee to decide if an investigation should take place.
Which he will.
I think that our students, our faculty, and actually the members of this police department at San Francisco City College deserve better than that.
Yeah.
So I ask that not only we get this passed with the 8 votes that are already on record in support of this resolution, we want a unanimous vote at the Board of Supervisors.
Yeah.
And we want not just the Board of Supervisors, but we want the chief executive of the city to also send the message that it is time to bring democracy back. Thank you very much.
Absolutely absurd. But you know what? It's not absurd. It has total meaning to the accrediting commission and the shadow government behind them. They don't want to increase enrollment. They want to lower enrollment. They tell me on the Board of Supervisors that I'm supposed to help encourage people to enroll in City College. And at the same time, they're putting up barriers to enrollment. Yesterday, a young man named Otto Pippinger, who I know for a number of years, I know his family, his father David, his mom Heidi, his brother Mo in Harlow, he was jacked up by the police department.
I saw a video.
Otto was on the ground. He was handcuffed.
He
was violently punched.
Shame! 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 Shame!
I know what Otto is. A gentle, gentle spirit. An artist. Someone who has like spent his life writing and doing video and doing art. And actually, he's the eldest in his family, and all his brothers below him have the same interests. These are like young geniuses, really, because I used to call them the Glass family, like in J.D. Salinger. The Glass family were all these genius kids. That's who Otto is. The Otto's fighting for a better world, and he really, really cares. And yet, what does he do when he actually tries to assert his rights? What does the police department do? They jack him up. To Otto, who I know asserts peaceful demonstration, we need to be peaceful, but we also need to make sure that our voices are louder, our anger is heard, that we all collectively call together and ask for an investigation about what happened, and actually all contact the district attorney and ask for these false charges to be dropped.
To ask one of those students to come up right now and to tell you about what's happening at City College of San Francisco. Janelle Williams, please come up.
Janelle!
I want him to speak.
Go up.
Ian, you here?
Go up.
Yeah, come on up here.
Do it right now.
I just want to say that, you know, students are organizing, right?
Yeah.
We're not going to allow for these folks to come into our city, to come to our college, and to brutalize our students who just want a voice in our education, who just want a right to a better life, to a future.
Yeah.
We're not going to take this laying down. We're organizing. We're coming together. We're meeting on Monday to formulate some solutions and to investigate what happened and to really bring justice to City College, because this is not the City College of San Francisco that we know, right?
Yeah.
This is not the City College of San Francisco that we know. I've lived in this city for 27 years. I love San Francisco. I love what we've always represented. We have always supported our people. This is not right. Come on up here. He's an amazing activist. What is his name?
And I'm an immigrant. And I'm a
proud
member of the body. And with that, I'm here to talk about the what happened yesterday when we tried to occupy the student, the Conland Hall that was we were supposed to have a peaceful demonstration in. So basically, we wanted to have a peaceful demonstration to sit in for everyone to basically state our points, for us to represent our arguments in a democratic way. And with that, we were denied, and basically we were kind of like brutally attacked by the police. That was like really that was really unjust, to be honest. And and basically that I wasn't intending to basically come to the sit-in, but I just couldn't tolerate the injustice and oppression that's basically happening in our institution, and I had to do something. Push my way through, leave the guys there in the cold, living on the floor, singing songs, and like building community at the same time. And with that, we're here as a community. We're here like, to empower each other, and we're here as CCSF students. CCSF is where dreams come true, and we're here inside of us. Thank you.
Are in school and are here speaking for the community and
for affirmative action. So last summer, we really saw that there was a need of a community voice to making sure that City College remains within San Francisco. And thanks to all of you, we've now had over 10,000 individuals who've come to support City College in the Move City College Forward campaign. ASD 2121, our labor partners and students, we stand with you through this journey and making sure that City College of San Francisco remains our City College. Areas that Move City College Forward will focus on. One, accreditation. It is time for the Accreditation Commission to updated decision and, and ensure that our college remains accredited. Litigation. We thank City Attorney Dennis Herrera and our labor partners for really leveraging and utilizing the courts and lawsuits as an avenue to hit the pause button and make sure that we can go beyond the July time frame. So thank you, City Attorney Dennis. Third is legislation. As Assemblymember Tom Amiano mentioned, there are many vehicles and legislative bills moving through Sacramento right now, and we thank him for his leadership. Most immediately, Blue City College Forward campaign is focusing on stabilization funds for the college. It is now estimated that starting July 1, 2014, for the new fiscal year, the college will be losing approximately $23 million. Cannot withstand those cuts, so no cuts, and we need all of our elected officials to make sure that the stabilization fund happens. Last is around governance and accountability and why we're all here today. The special trustee and state chancellor, let's not forget the state chancellor's office, must present a clear plan and a timeline to when they're going to return governance to the locally elected Board of Trustees of San Francisco. As we know that policy decisions like the educational master plan is going to have lasting impact on the college for years and years to come, and we need transparency now. Our students and our communities are counting on us, and it's time to return City College to San Francisco.
Talk about testimony from students, community, and faculty. And we need those voices to be heard and to hear about the decisions that are being made by unelected, appointed folks at City College of San Francisco right now, and why it's so important that we bring the voice of San Francisco back to the City College of San Francisco. And I just want to end with one additional chant. Who's City College?
Our City College!
Who's City College?
Our City College!
Who's City College?
Our City College!
Thank you.
Storm the barricades now?